Welcome one and welcome all to another fun, exciting evening featuring Blasky and myself, Dorix, probing the depths of space. And that's as far as we're going to go with
that's
that.
Are we going to stop there? Okay, that was great. Thank you.
I swear I had something.
Well, I mean, I guess that worked better than the first intro that we did when I forgot to change the scene. That didn't work. So
we don't need to tell anyone that.
No, that's fine. We won't mention that.
Redacted.
Hello, everybody. Yes, welcome to Acid Space Reaction Theory, which is the name of tonight's stream. Oh, excellent.
Oh, what a great little.
Oh, okay, hockey's working there. Now. We're all good. We're all good. Welcome. Yes, FSM Imp may or may not be joining us, but we can't get hold of her right now. So we're just going to play for a bit, and if she turns up, then all the better. That was a cheeky lag test. That was instantaneous. Came up on my screen, mate. Instantaneous.
Well, it doesn't come up instantly on mine.
Does it not?
Because I have the... Okay, wow, that's way faster, though.
Is it? We're way faster than Restream?
Yeah, do you want me to time it? I can benchmark this.
I mean, we can benchmark it if you're interested, but when you type it, it comes on the chat instantaneously, so we don't have to wait for Restream to read the chat, which is kind of cool.
Yeah, that's good. I meant, like, but now me as a viewer,
yeah,
it still takes, you know, but that's just the built-in time.
It is. So we have moved away from Restream for the first time ever. All the times we've streamed, we've been using Restream, but tonight we are using just Twitch, so we have a nice sexy new chat window, which took a bit of getting up to. So let us know what you think. See if you like the new setup, see if it's a bit quicker, see if you enjoy it. We are definitely going to do your comic, so for those who don't know, it is a chat that Gibu can't break as well. Yes, I made sure of that. Gibu has spent all day making a comic about the channel. I believe it's a Rocket League related comic, but even though we're playing Space Engineers tonight, we'll still take a look at it, Gibu, don't you worry. Let's wait and see if a few more people turn up first before we do that. But I am very excited to see what it's like. You've been bigging it up all evening, so we will see. We'll see. I can't wait. Alrighty, so let's jump on in to the action. There we go, lovely. So, yeah. See, that doesn't now cause problems. Yeah, it's true. And now, because we're not using Restream as well, I can use the moderation functions on the bot, so if anyone does put a link up, I can get it shortened if it's too long. So the link still goes through, but now it's shortened. And unlike with Restream, it would display that, but now it won't do that. So everything is very good.
Nice.
All right.
And it's good that you can instantly now see the chat.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. Oh, I did forget to put a bonus tag on this stream. Wait, I think actually I can change that in real time now as well.
Oh boy.
Let me... Because now we're not using Restream, we don't have to go through a different website.
We have the technology.
Oh, boom. Check it out. Check it out. There we go. All right. So what is it that we were doing?
So I'm just welding up some stuff in the bottom pod thing here.
Okay.
Ooh, but...
Oh, I mean, know what I was doing.
We still need a comp... Oh, go ahead.
Oh, no, please. We still need to what?
We still need some sort of, like, interdiction ship or something that we can use to actually, like, combat things.
Yeah.
Because, like, there's a military transport that's, like, ripe for the picking. Actually, do you want to just do it manually?
I mean, I think we should, right?
EVA it?
I think we should just EVA it and go and take this thing down. Like, it's going to be challenging, but I think we can do it. So, okay, I need to get into... We have some problems with the hangar bay doors on this side. Some of them are open, some of them are closed. It's a bit of a mess.
Oh, that one we'll have to kind of troubleshoot.
Oh, massive lag spike.
I like... No, oh, sorry.
It's all right.
I like Sydney's idea... I can still hear myself, by the way.
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't actually turn the speakers down. Oh, I've just broken the mic. We're all good. It's fine. Everything's fine. It's a bonus stream. It's good. The bonus streams we can do less professionally and it doesn't matter. That's what I keep telling myself anyway.
Also, I wish we had... You know what we should think about? Building one of Gibu's crazy things, but I want like a rail cannon on this ship. Like, why don't we have a static cannon? This thing's only 3.6 clicks away, and you have visual on it.
We do have visual on it.
I should be able to shoot a railgun at it, or like some sort of projectile.
Maybe we can make a clang weapon with this. That would be pretty good fun. I think we should try and do that, certainly. Okay, I've dumped all my stuff, but I've got my level 3 weapons. I guess I've got a hydrogen bottle as well, which I don't really need, but that's fine. I'm good to go.
Yeah, I think what we should do this one at a time. Because if this vector right here is going to be in the sights of the cannons, we're not going to have a chance.
Yeah.
So, like, I'll go first. And okay. If I end up dead because I'm in the firing solution, see, then you can maybe come, like,
from a different shoot angle. Out,
like, a couple kilometers to the left and then go in, and maybe there'll be a blind spot.
I guess I'm out of range of you now. How far away from the transport are you?
1.5.
Oh, okay, you're way closer than I am. Have you made contact?
Yeah.
Safely?
Oh, shit. It has a 360-degree firing solution.
Oh, okay.
So I wouldn't do it. Unless, maybe, I don't know what the range of the guns are, but I had to get about 800 meters before the turret started shooting me.
Okay. But then you just got annihilated quickly, did you?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I tried ducking around to a corner, but it did not work.
So I'm at a click out. So
you can give it a shot.
Are they the turrets on the top? They're like three turrets on the top, maybe?
There's a turret on the side, too. I don't know if there's a turret directly at the front. I wish there was a zoom, because they can kind of visually figure out if it's going to be safe.
How worthwhile is this?
We're looking for a large shot. Like, we're talking about nothing in terms of cost to us.
That's true. I think we should try it. Gibby says, if you set off one of those antennas, I hope you have a barrage of missile turrets ready at your base. We have none of those things.
Don't worry. The ship will kill us before it needs to even raise the alarm. But you're right, I wonder what the range of the missile turrets are. We could build a missile bank on the roof of this thing.
Maybe that would be a plan. Alright, it's now coming towards me. I'm right at the front. Should I go in, do you think? Should I try?
Yeah.
Alright, let's see.
The worst thing that could happen is you die, and it also then starts doing the, like, need help, send assistance. Because then we won't be able to turn those off.
Yes. Okay, I see a turret. Oh, I died immediately. Oh, there's two turrets on the front. Yeah.
Yeah, there. It's got a pretty good.
It seems pretty military, honestly. I guess the clue's in the name, but
Oh, was there any on the bottom?
I didn't see, but
I was watching your body careen into it, and it did not look like anything was on the bottom.
Ah. Okay. Interesting.
Like, I think it's worth trying again.
You want to go again?
On the bottom. Yeah.
All right. Well, I'll tell you what I'll do. I'll take some level one crappy gear.
All right. Do not enter airlock.
Okay. Thank you.
Airlock secure.
All right.
Although I don't have the, it's not, I don't see it anymore.
Neither do I, but I guess I could find my body, right? Oh, wait, what? Oh, I'm being bounced around. Oh, it's desynced again already. It's got me on the wrong side of the door. Come on. Oh, there we go. I fixed it.
Okay.
There we go. Okay. I actually don't see it either.
Do you see your body tag?
Yeah, body's over here. Oh, do you see me? Like, sorry, I left pretty quickly there. Do you? I'm below you.
I do now.
You got me?
I got you.
So it was coming towards me, so I imagine it will be to the right of this GPS.
I mean, it'll either have despawned or we'll pick it up on, radar. But we would have probably seen it by now.
Right, I think
it's despawned. How close are we to your body?
Two clicks.
Yeah, because we spot these things when they're like 5.
Yeah, well, eight. We saw it like way further. Yeah, I think it must have despawned.
It's probably despawned. All right, I'm going to return back.
Okay, I'm going to pick up my body, actually, as I'm here. Might as well go for it. See if we can pick up the stuff. Stuffies. Oh, I just... Whoa. That was... It's a little fast. Wow, I didn't actually see... I didn't see my bits anywhere. Where's my bits? I mean, I was going towards it, right? So did they just fly off? They probably just flew off, didn't they, forever? Flying forever. Huh. Okay. Back home we go. Yeah. So maybe we do need to build like a proper military ship. So one with decoys. One that doesn't have rotors. And something that we can actually go and hunt these things down with. Maybe some missiles, that kind of thing.
Yeah. Like the X-Wing.
Yeah. Or more like the Y-Wing, honestly. Which I think was more successful.
That was a fucking tank.
That it was an absolute tank, yeah.
I honestly think that... Well, it would build the flavor to have, like, a real shippy ship. Honestly, I think a drop ship is what we need. A ship that's really heavy armored, that can move in within really close distance, and then unload a person to attack. Because if we actually want to, like, capture these ships, we need to be more like piratey and try boarding parties. So I wonder if building just more of a tank that a person... We have like an open bottom drop port that we can just basically fly really mm-hmm. close to the ship. The person can fly out and then that ship can get away.
So what I'm hearing is let's build a Raptor, right? That's what I'm hearing.
Yeah. Or more like a Cylon heavy...
Raiders. Or the heavy... Yeah, they're called Raiders. Heavy Raiders, I think, weren't they?
Yeah.
All right, cool. So should we both... Do we want to do a team build? Do we want to do a pair building or...
I was going to actually build a missile battery on top of our ship.
Okay. I will go down into... Should I go down into the bottom bit? Is that our construction place, or should I stay in the hangar?
I mean, you can build it wherever. I honestly would build it outside of the ship.
Oh, we just got like, shelled.
Whoa. Meteor's doing some damage?
Yeah. That very nearly killed me. Like, that was... the meteor nearly hit me.
I see one just clipped our...
Oh, dude, there's a mining carriage. Isn't the mining carriage the one that's, like... not that defensible, but usually has a lot of stuff in it?
Yeah, let's go for it. What damage did that thing do? Just one hit on the bow?
Yeah, so it's chipped away, like, a chunk of the what's it called?
How are these... All these turrets not doing anything, or was it from the bottom?
I don't know which direction it came from, honestly. But these turrets are all on, aren't they? Is this one on?
There should be.
Yeah, it's on. And it's got loads of ammo.
The mining carriage is going to have a ton of ore, so I think we should hit it.
Oh, it's the massive one that we had, right? That got sheared in half.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. Should we hit it, yeah?
Yeah.
All right.
It's got only turrets, I think, on one side. On okay. the top. It doesn't have any batteries, just two reactors.
Hmm. And then you're 7 o'clock high.
Alright. All squads, report in.
Rogue leader, standing by.
Red October, standing by. I think Zoe's laughing at the Red October joke.
That's a quality gag.
I think, or my Sean Connery impression. Either one. Alright, I'm gonna go wide
mm-hmm.
and you should stay on target.
I'll stay
on
track.
This diversifies our attack mm-hmm. vector.
Our Gibu needs an explanation of Red October.
It's a great, great movie.
It is.
Or a Tom Clancy novel, really.
It's the name of the submarine, right?
Yeah.
Okay, well, this is perfectly safe from this side. I don't remember where the turrets are.
Oh, fuck, turrets on that. It killed me.
Oh, you found the turrets.
It's on the other side. But you need to rotate around a little bit and shoot the antenna.
Where is the antenna?
It's on the other side of the ship.
Oh, shit.
But just move left. A little.
Oh, I don't know if I can get this fast enough. Before the decoys.
Or just hit both reactors.
I got him.
That's all you have to do. If you've hit both reactors, then you're fine.
It started shooting me.
It'd be better to hit the reactors, actually. I'm sorry.
That's okay. It's okay, mate.
Because luckily there's no batteries, so...
Oh, but it's not better to hit the reactors, though, right? Because we want the dampeners to turn on.
But if you hit the reactors first, that kills the antenna and the turrets.
Okay, right? Well, the antenna's dead, actually, but it hasn't killed the turret. Yeah, okay, so you hit the reactors first, then destroy the turret.
And then you can put the reactors... everything and the antenna. You know what I mean? Like,
yeah,
from an attack standpoint, if we would have both just hit the reactors, we could have had both reactors down at the same time very quickly.
Yeah. Gibu thinks just go straight for the seat. But if I go this way, then I can take out the turret.
Plus, like, if this ship had interior turrets and stuff, like, now it's safe to, like, inspect the ship. Like, mm-hmm. while it's still difficult because it's moving, at least now you're not going to get blasted.
That's right.
Like, all it would take is some trolley developers to have an interior turret sitting at the cockpit chair, right? And then...
Trolley developers.
That's what I'd do.
Yeah, I know, right? Definitely.
I would design ships with interior turrets.
Well, I just remember that
procedurally located.
Yeah, the door is pretty powerful on its own, honestly. So
only if you weld it while you're standing in the threshold.
I guess so. Wow, I really like this. This grinder is taking a long time to get through this.
So the
door.
Same thing happened to me, and when you were doing it, or I had 20 energy when I was at that door. So I'm like, oh god, like you got to get this door down and in the seat.
Yeah, Gibby says he goes around the door, and honestly, that's a pretty good call. Should probably have done that. Nearly there. Riveting.
Boy. Everyone excited watching Blasky grind?
That's a different stream.
Hey, LMAO.
Alright.
Okie dokie.
Get those reactors back up. Wait, what? Where are the reactors? Oh, they're on this side. Here we go, they're on the bottom. On the bottom. How about we'll do the comic, Gibu, after I've got this mining carriage back to base. How about that? Does that sound good?
Man, I had one health this time. After smashing into something too fast. I feel like my suit is way more maneuverable for whatever reason.
Oh, wrong side. All right.
You're like, we're okay.
Yeah, I mean, sure. Sure. I mean, it probably is because now you're not fighting the lag, right? Because now you've got server shotgun, which is something
right.
You've not been used to. There we go, dampeners on. All right, home is 10 clicks out. Bringing her home.
All righty. How's the stores look, or have you not had a chance yet? Oh, you have a really bad, so.
I can check.
It might just say access denied.
Probably will, but we can still see the inventory, right, even if it's access denied? No, you can't. It doesn't let you do that. I'm bringing 20 uranium. Yeah, it's not too bad, is it?
Nice. So do we want to take the little mining things off of Gibu's ship and replace them with grinders to grind it down, or do we want to keep this for, like, an actual ship we can use to fly around?
I don't know. It's just not very maneuverable. I'm not sure there's a huge advantage to keeping it.
Like, we could probably just grind it down and get all the stuff.
Right.
And then just use that all in the dropship, you know?
Yeah, exactly. We'll use that to replace the stuff we use for the dropship, because I'll probably do that simultaneously. If I start on the dropship, maybe while you grind this down or something like that. Okie dokie. All right. 3 clicks out. I've realized why the hotkey didn't work. I had the bot window open and the chat selected. So it's instead it was typing in the chat box, which is why the hotkey didn't do it.
So now BlaskyBot we can really go ham with,
we
right?
We can, yeah. Yeah, BlaskyBot has like full authoritative power now.
Oh, your friend or foe beacon is still out. Oh my god, you're going to crash into a ship, aren't you?
No, I'm not. I wasn't going to crash, but now I need to get away very quickly.
No, because... you're fine. Everything's turned off.
Oh, is it? All right.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, because...
I'm sure our turrets are having, like, a whinge or whatever.
They're probably having a little
British
whinge.
People say. Because they're like, we want to shoot the shit out of this thing.
Yeah.
So, sorry for the false alarm.
No, it's fine. I did panic, but I think we're all good. So should I? I'll try and dock again, right? On the top, like you did.
Yeah. Do you need help?
We'll try. We'll see.
Honestly think you can do it if you change your view. And
yeah.
I for whatever reason forgot I could do that, and then once I changed the view, it wasn't too bad.
Okay, oh, we something have one is shooting me.
One turret is shooting you. I'm turning it off.
Okay.
Sorry.
I don't know how much damage it did.
I don't know. The turret group must be missing one or something.
It probably is, yeah. Any new stuff isn't added automatically.
And how do you add stuff?
You have to select it all and then create a new group with the same name. And it just overwrites the current one. This is pretty hard to do because it's as far away as possible from the thing.
Oh, I was able to. Oh.
Am I in?
You can just control click everything and then hit save.
Oh, can you? That's pretty good. I guess I'm not in. I've made contact. I guess it's not quite straight. Oh. Is that? Okay, I could use a little bit of guidance, okay. I think.
Head towards the planet a little.
Like that?
And now towards the ship a little. No, I'm sorry. Altitude. You're super close now.
Okay. So downwards.
That was fast.
That was fast?
Like, so fast it blew the connector off.
That was fast? That was like 2 meters away from it. How was that?
And like almost killed me.
What happened?
So we're gonna need to weld a new connector. Also, if we didn't hack that connector, it was never gonna work.
Oh, I didn't hack the connector.
So I have a feeling we were close enough because it was really, really close.
Okay. That was ridiculous because I was doing less than a meter a second, I'm pretty sure.
Just back it up a little bit and we'll slap on a new connector and we'll be fine.
Do I need to back it up or are we good?
We're probably okay.
I think it looks like we're good. Whoops. Well, the base is fine. It's just a...
Do you have any computers?
Well, I don't think so. I think I dropped everything. Oh no, apparently I do.
Oh,
yeah.
There we go. Okay, so now it should be possible.
Alright, can we get rid of these landing gears? Yeah.
Yeah, I don't have any space to grind them down.
Oh, dude, it's just a slow grind.
Alright.
Asteroid base with mega grind pit. Oh, I've seen that before. Yeah, that's super cool. So you can basically set up a massive pit with a ton of grinders in it and then just fly the ship into it. And that's how it grinds. It's pretty great.
All right. You're super close.
I think I got it.
There we go. I did it. I mean, honestly, with the way the ship's hooked up now, we could just grind from the back down.
Oh, and that's it's not true. Move. Yeah. All right, but we need to grind just down and then back up for all these things, don't we? So that we can get to the stuff inside.
No, you can just hack all the large cargo containers.
Well, if you don't grind them down to hack them and then grind them back up again, when you grind through them, they will just drop out, right?
Yeah, I'm sorry. You just have to hit each of the cargo containers.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Manually, and then we can. But you should be able to hit. You should be able to get to all of them without having to break anything.
Oh, Giba's been thrown into a grinder pit before in the passenger seat. That's horrible. Poor Giba.
I don't have the components though for one of them. I think you must have put them in the connector.
The components for one of what? Sorry.
The cargo containers. It's missing a computer and display, or maybe it was just damaged then.
It was probably just damaged, yeah, because I've not ground anything down, so.
Oh.
I was actually just, what the hell is this?
What?
Oh, this large cargo container is like, it's a total mess. What is all this stuff? Like, why is it all? We have 3,000 thruster components. What large cargo container is this?
Oh, that's all the stuff I dragged out of the grinders. The grinders don't auto-stack.
Oh, I see. So this is the stuff from the previous ship.
Yeah. Holy also, I just hell. Sucked everything out of the ship.
Oh, right. Yeah, of course.
So it actually had a bunch of cobalt, which is nice.
Oh, cool. Man, this is some serious stuff going on here.
Yeah, so I think I'm just going to now grind it.
Okay, yeah. Well, before you do, let's get yourself up on stream, and I'll see Gibu's. Let's have a look at Gibu's creation, his delightful creation. So I've got to scroll up and get the link. There it is. I didn't even click it. I've not seen any of it. Not seen any of it so far. We're gonna move this.
Are you gonna share the browser or something so we can see it?
I'm just
on big screen.
Holy shit, this is the greatest. This might be the best thing that's ever been made.
Are you gonna share it on the big screen?
Oh, I am. Sorry, I was setting it up and this is absolute quality. Hang on. What would be the best way of doing this? I think if I just do. Let's just do window capture again. Yeah, we'll have browser. Boom, there we go. I think I'm gonna. Should I be doing the voice acting here as well, Gibu?
You've got to do. Does the voice acting.
Hang on. Let me just have a quick browse down.
All right, you might want to hide it then, so you don't spoil it.
No, I'm doing it. Don't worry. I'm just trying to work out if you need to say anything. Looks like it's just me. So here we go.
Oh boy.
Everybody, Gibu's amazing creation. Thank you for this, Gibu. Here it is in all of its glory. Hello everyone and welcome back to Blaskatronic TV, your number one choice for watching a British man play video games. And today we're back with some more Rocket League. As always, I'm joined by Mike and Shmev. Oh dear, it looks as if we have some technical issues. Uh-oh, some big technical issues going on here with this car, that doesn't look good. GameGeeper has joined the chat. Hi guys. Hey, I'm sorry I didn't get the comic to you soon, I just wanted to make sure I got the hair right, I spent a lot of time trying to... This is great.
It's so meta.
Hey, Gibu's here. Whoa, calm down. You do not have to apologize for anything. We understand, Gibu. I want you to know I really appreciate you doing the comic, and I can't wait to see it, but take your time.
Beep boop.
That's me.
There we go. This is you, actually. This is, because I remember Gibu asked me about it. So do you want to give us your best for this, Mike?
Oh, Gibu's here. Beep boop.
Perfect. Good job. All right, there's my checklist.
Starscream
botched intro. Botched it twice. Gibu's here. Beep boop. Say something quite British. Calculated. This is
way anchor.
Right, let's get to it then, shall we? Are we good to go? Let's see if we can win a few games this time around. How's that sound, Gibu? Way anchor. Absolutely. Look at this. This is some quality shit. Like, Gibu.
This is good.
This is amazing. Seriously, dude. All right. Later on. Oh, yeah, there we go. Some rainbow spirals. Boosh. Good job, everyone. Great play. And Gibu with the clip, with the mad clips. I think, actually, if I remember rightly, let me just see if I think... that one, maybe? I think that's your boosh clip, Gibu. I might have got the number wrong, but... there we go. Mike's really been going ham these last few rounds. Plenty of calculated. All I have to do is go forward. That's another classic moment. Gaming with Colby has joined the chat. Thank you. Oh my god. That is the best thing. Oh, Gibu, you have absolutely done it, mate.
God,
you have absolutely done it. That is exactly...
Oh,
I'm trying to... Wait, can I... Holy shit, I can't even... That is quality. That is supreme quality.
Oh, man.
Release the chat mod.
Yeah, 10 out of 10.
Absolutely 10 out of 10. Completely genius. This is getting saved immediately. Like, I love it. I absolutely love it.
We need to, like, immortalize it in the Library of Congress. Like, it's, yeah. It's quality here.
It is. That is supreme. Let's get that saved. We're going to call it Best Comic Ever. Lovely. Thank you so much for doing that, Gibu. There's a lot of effort that's gone into that, and I really appreciate it, honestly. Top man. Thank you very much. I hope I did it justice. Excellent stuff. Oh, okie dokie. Back we go.
Alright, I'm just retrofitting Gibu's ship.
Alright.
Replacing the mining drills with...
Oh, I've got grinders. One oxygen left. I need to breathe. Whew! Nearly killed me, that comic. I couldn't breathe because I was laughing so hard and had no oxygen. Oh, that ending was quality. He was a bit worried about the ending. He wasn't sure how to end it. Like, that's the way you end it.
That was brilliant.
Absolutely 10 out of 10. Good job, mate.
That was so good.
Okay. So. Oh, you're doing the retrofitting, right? Okay, yeah. So I was gonna start.
Do you want to work on the dropship?
I can work on the dropship. Just before we do that, I'm gonna. I wanted to do some lights. I wanted to do some runway lights because I had an idea about how to do.
Then you should also, while you're just kind of doing stuff like that, is fix those doors if you don't mind.
Okay, I'll do that.
I think the way to do it, Sydney had a good idea, is basically just grind down that entire side just enough to where they're all incomplete, and then it should be easy to make the group.
Okay, yeah.
I need some. Or something, I don't know, whatever, yeah.
It tells you if something's damaged, doesn't it? So I think it. I think one way of doing it, and it might not be the best way, but one way of doing it would be to make them damaged but not grind them down completely. And then you should be able to group them up by searching for damaged.
Okay.
Just an idea. I don't know. I'll look in a bit.
Just make sure there's no other damaged landing doors and restart.
Right, exactly, yeah. I'll mess everything up.
Alright, I hope it being attached to the ship is gonna work. Because if not, this is dangerous because we're kind of close to our ship.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, if something, and it's right in the middle as well, so if something falls through, it goes all the way through. I mean, there's no gravity, so it shouldn't actually go down, but not when I
bump it, my ship.
Well, I mean, that's true. If you go downwards and then bump it, that would be pretty sad. Did you see Shmev in the comic? I might admit, did I miss that? Let me see. I'll load it up again.
Hey, your blast spot's a little outdated there.
Where is he? Oh, I do see him! Oh, okay, no, this is an excellent little reference. Okay. I gotta put this back up again. One second. Yeah, I did it. I missed this bit. This is brilliant. Brilliant. Thanks a lot, my Windows Microsoft Photo.exe. What the hell's this? Rubbish. Wow, it's laggy. That's really bad, isn't it? Okay, we'll just get rid of this. And we'll add the whole display in.
Wow.
Yeah, quality stuff, eh? Add existing display. Boom, there we go. Check it out! Here's Shmev doing his power pose! Isn't that great?
That's good.
That is quality.
What the fuck? I don't look that roly poly, do I? Jeez, Gibu. The camera adds 10 pounds.
The camera adds 10 pounds. Oh dear. Byproduct of resizing, he says.
Okay, yeah. No, it's fine. I'm just giving you a hard time, man. Like, really, I don't care.
That's extreme.
I thought it was really funny when it was zoomed in, I noticed. Like, whoa.
Just a second.
Like the Roly Poly Adama, like season 4 or something.
Oh, mate, no, not that bad. Jeez, not even close.
That is like such a cheesy thing.
It's...
when he,
oh god.
When like they have a little montage of him training.
I know. And then he takes the fat suit off. Like the obvious fat suit.
Yeah, exactly, in
the
next scene.
Yeah. Oh dear. I mean, it's kind of funny, but it is really cheesy, you're right. Like, it's probably the cheesiest thing in the whole... in the whole season, like the whole series, because it's certainly not a cheesy show.
No.
The original was.
I've never seen the original.
I've never seen full episodes of the original, but I've seen little bits, and Yeah, it looked pretty. It looked very 70s sci-fi, right? Like, all of the stereotypes seemed to apply. Oh, come on. I find these interior lights so difficult to weld. You have to be exactly on them. There we go.
Are you doing some RGB goodness? Can they blink?
Oh, mate, you just wait and see. I've got this sorted.
Okay.
I have a plan.
Sorry if I just spoil it, because I hope you can do what I want you to, like, what should be done.
It's going to be done. It's going to be done. I, like a Cylon, I have a plan.
Everything has happened before.
Actually, this has. I did it on the Galactica ship that we made. I think, actually, if I put the control panel here, just kind of out the way. Oh, I need a computer and a display. Oh, no, we can use it. We're fine. We can use it without a computer. It's just a steel plate and a construction component. It's just a bit of iron welded to the side of a wall. But somehow it allows me to control things, so.
All right, watch out. There's some girders coming down.
What is this one? Oh, what's happened?
They got away from me.
They've broken free. It's broken loose.
I'll take care of that.
I got these, don't worry.
The little pieces fly off and I try to chase them down and sometimes they get away.
Alright, I got him. Wait, are these lined up?
These are free range.
They're free
small range. Steel plates.
Okay.
Release the chat mod. No, I think Colby's probably grounded or something.
I think he's been banned. Not by us. We didn't do it. We came pretty close.
Maybe his mother.
I'm not gonna lie. So 30, 30, 30, 29. Some of these have different colours. So I'm guessing the ones that have colours are not the ones I just placed. That would make sense. Oh, which side am I on, Mike? Is this have you called this the aft, or is this the...
It's the side that the doors work. I cannot remember. Sydney did the actual naming. We discussed about what to name them, but I can't recall off the top of my head which is the front of the ship and which is the rear of the ship.
Okay. Closed, open. Yeah, we're at the stern on this side, apparently, according to the naming nomenclature. So that seems good. Interior. So what I'm going to do is we need to...
Are they exterior?
Nope. These are interior lights.
Oh, okay. And they look like they're on the outside of the ship.
They're on the outside of the ship, but the block is called an interior light.
Oh, so would you give it shouldn't it be like stern exterior landing lights?
I don't get into that. Jeez.
Oh, okay. I was confused. When I heard you say interior lights, I realized now you're probably searching for the block.
I was. That's exactly what I was doing.
But at first, I'm like,
yeah.
That's a terrible name. Exterior lights, stern. You're outside. Of course.
We'll know what it means. It's fine.
Standard, like, it's like variable, descriptive variable names.
Yeah, you know? Exactly. Okay, so...
I just had a good idea. What if we put an artificial gravity generator on the front of the grinder ship? So things fell to it. Would that work? Like, could you put a grinder...
Say again, sorry. I wasn't paying attention.
What if you put an artificial gravity generator behind your grinder so things would fall into it?
Oh.
Or be pulled into it?
Instead
of having to
cool
chase
idea.
It down.
Yeah, you can have it like really localized as well, so that would work.
Sorry, I've been enjoying this fresh fruit margarita.
Lovely.
What have you been drinking?
I had a beer before, but I've just got water left now. But your margarita sounds delicious.
Oh, it is so good. It's always great at making them.
5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So there should be 6 and 6, which I think there are. So best bet here. Right. Need one red. I can't say stern and left, can I?
No.
Is
it?
But I'll just go
either like port or starboard.
I'm defining port as the side where the control tower is. Okay, so starboard is the far side of the hangar.
Okay.
And port is the bit where the engineering bay is. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Okay. So runway light. Okay. Yeah. Yeah. Best way of doing this. Best way to do this.
So if you're facing the front of the ship, port should be the left side. Like, it still needs to be right-handed.
Oh, crap.
I guess it's not called
right-handed. Yeah,
but,
you're right.
Like, there's a handedness to...
There is, yeah. So stern, hang on. Stern is front, right?
Yeah.
So this is starboard, then.
No, stern is the rear. Bow is the front.
The bow is the front, sorry. I always think it's stern and aft, because aft is rear as well, isn't it?
Ooh. Now I'm starting to question everything.
I mean, I'm not going to lie. My nautical knowledge so far on stream has not been the best. So, with the whole weigh anchor debacle. So.
Weigh anchor.
Oh, I can't rename all of these blocks simultaneously at the same time. That's not good.
Jerry and Martha.
All right. Okay, for now, what we're going to do is we're just going to rename all that. And I'm pretty sure these are all correct. The numbers look right. I don't know why we've got multiple 30s, but...
I think yeah, the auto-incrementing thing's kind of broken
when
things merge.
A little bit messed up, isn't it? Okay, great. Let's make all of these red. For a second to see if it's done the right thing. Lovely. All right. Okay. Do we get any further about what stern is and?
No. We should just have BlaskyBot or one of our followers. If you could do a little ASCII diagram of a ship, and then it labeled, that would be phenomenal.
That would be pretty great. Okay, right, hang on. The stern and bow is what they've been named as, right? And the bow is definitely the front, because you get a bow wave, right? Which is at the front.
Yeah, bow is the front.
So the stern is definitely the rear.
What confused me is when, what was it? Aft?
Yeah.
I don't... Is...
What's that used in? Because I've heard that on a ship, I'm sure. But then what's the front? Is it bow and aft? That doesn't sound right.
Maybe, yeah, I don't know.
I'm confused. I don't know.
I don't know. My small boat sailing knowledge is a long time ago.
Right. Okay, so let me see. So we want the stern. So I want the left one is actually not left at all. This is because I'm pointing forwards through the ship. Wait, it is. It is then. So this is still port, I think. Right, we're going to make them all green, except for bow, stern, fore and aft. That's right, the fore. There we go. And then port and starboard. There we go. Thank you, Gibu. Gibu knows what's up. Of course he does. I mean, why are we surprised? That's, Right, I'm going to make this one red.
Do you mind opening the doors? Are you near a control panel?
I absolutely am. I will do that right
now.
I
was talking to Sydney. What we need to do is add the remote control on the ship.
Mm-hmm.
So then a ship doesn't need people.
Yeah. Why can't I? What's happening?
Man, it'd be really cool to use a programming block or something to where you could then have the. I'm sure the lights are going to be phenomenal, but they're going to be even. They'd be really cool too if they were color coded based off door status.
Yeah, I'm not doing that. So it would be cool, but I'm currently not doing that. Is what I mean.
I didn't mean to do that. Yeah, I just meant like.
Do you want to do that? Is that what you want or?
Someday. It doesn't need to be now.
Okay.
I have to look up how to do it with like programming blocks or whatever.
Starboard as well. I kind of wish. Yeah, hang on. If I put this in a more sensible place, I don't have to keep going in and out of it, which would be useful. Let's see. I could put this here. And then in the options, turn the thing down. Okay. This should be a little bit easier to work out what's going on now. So we've got this one, which is blue. This one is starboard. So we name it stern. I put starbound. Wow, that's because I'm. I mean, that game's amazing. Starbound's fantastic. Just antenna yourself with. Oh, I could antenna it as well. Didn't think about that. Well, I think we kind of have. We have this. This appears to be working. So, starboard. There we go. This one is. It's that one there. So that one is also starboard. Boop. Make that one red. This one is also starboard. And then this one is also starboard. Great. Oops, red. Now, if we ignore this one for a second, we can have these blinking.
Ooh, that flew off at a high velocity.
Oh. Oh, there we go. This is what I was looking for. I'll stop scrolling up.
Uh-oh.
Something like that. Can I set this to be an exact number? Or is it just a very difficult slider to do anything useful with? Nah, that'll do.
Alright, I just got a refill on my margarita.
Oh, nice. Good stuff.
Man, we've gotten so many interior plates from this thing.
That's pretty good.
And there's a lot of pieces floating off into space. I forgot the way that this thing was set up, where they're like shells around the cargo bay.
Mm-hmm.
So once the cargo bay fell off, everything just separated out and floated away. But I've tracked down the engines because those have the most stuff.
Okay.
How are the lights coming?
Nearly there with the first phase. Let's see, we've got 6 lights, right? No, we've only got 5 lights. Oh, I'm missing one. That's why. Presumably that one, yeah. Stern, starboard, red. Okay. So, set this one. These all need to have the same blink interval and length. I don't quite know what I want yet. Nah, 5 seconds is too long. 3 seconds, probably. With a 10-ish percent blink length. No, that's too short. Wow, stop flicking up. Why do you do that? Super intense light. Blinding light.
Uh-oh.
Oh, is it? I think it's because stuff is changing on the ship, right? I think that's why it keeps scrambling what it is that I'm looking at.
Well, nothing's changing anymore. It's all floating away.
Oh, good. Bye. Bye, ship.
I think what was really messing you up is there's a single interior light on this ship.
Oh, really? 12. Man, why does it have to be 6? Ugh. 16, isn't it? 16. Okay, so 0. We set this one to 16-ish percent. We set these then to 32. And then we set these to...
I really like how the grinders automatically spit stuff out.
Yeah. It's pretty great. 48.
No link.
And these 56, right? No, 66. That's not right. What have I done wrong here?
Oh, Givu, sorry. To answer your question, it's the I removed the last cargo container on that ship, and that was what the docking port was connected to, so it floated away.
Right. So this is because, although I have 6 lights, I only have 5 intervals between them. So I need to divide it by 5, not 6. So this is a 60. That makes this an 80.
What side of the ship were you working on?
The stern, apparently.
Which is the rear.
Mm-hmm. Too long.
So I think you might have mixed up the red and the green.
I'm working literally on one line right now. The greens are placeholders.
Oh, sorry. I thought they were like on ships. You have the red and the green on one side and the other side, so you can tell at a distance what side of the ship.
Nope, that's not what
okay.
I was doing.
Sorry.
Because once I've set this up, I can just copy the settings over to the other ones, so it should be lot better. It feels a little slow. Why does it... why did you do that? Don't do this, game! Here we go. So, it still feels a little slow, so let's drop this down to like... Oh, that's better. I like that. Okay. Good. These are all... Oh, I can't rename these.
Link, you need to have some chill if you want to sell my laptop and play this.
Causing problems.
We just want the tension. No.
So 1.3 and 26.4. We can set those. Thank you. And then all of these should be at 0. And then these should be at 20. These should be at 40. These should be at 60. These should be at 80. And this one should be at 100. The ordering's not right. God, how do I even work out what the hell's going on here? Oh, bollocks. Why is the ordering not right? It should have put them in the right order. Oh, man. Oh, look at
it. It looks like the first one's right. On. And the last. The first two and the last two are synced, so.
Yeah.
Oh, that's a good idea, Gibu.
Oh, am I dying? Oh, I've got no oxygen.
I've got oxygen in the ship.
Where's the closest oxygen? I'm probably gonna die before I get there. Come on.
Oh, there's in the ship.
Oh, I see. Oh, it's gonna be close. Get in. That was...
Did you make it or did you die?
I made it, and I had 3 health. This is the last fraction.
Oh, wow. 3 health?
3 health. Like, half a second more, and that would have been curtains. 3% Jesus. Health.
Oh, my God, Link. What the... Like... He's determined to just be on my neck. Yeah.
Not a margarita kid, no.
Oh man, I didn't even think about the fact that he's on Jesus! Okay, Link, you're done.
I'm cutting you off.
Those were claws in the shoulder.
That's not good.
Oh, I'm sorry, I didn't realize that he was on no. The microphone. So that was...
No, it's...
That's what a cat's ass sounds like.
Yeah. Okay. Why did that keep happening? I'm halfway through doing something and it just flicks to something totally random. Red 1. Red 2. Red 3. Red 4. Red 5. And red leader. Okay. So now I need to know... All right, what color, the yellow one is the, okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so that can be 6 or 1. We're gonna call it 1. Okay, I need to move so I can see this all at the same time. Man, this is hard. This is harder than I was expecting it to be. I don't remember it being this hard when I first did it. So the yellow one, this can be red 1. Alright. And then this one.
We have the ship antenna, Gabe, it was on our ship's saucer.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. That's how it works. 4.
Have you tried the show on HUD thing, Maddie?
Yes. No. I haven't, but that makes a lot of sense.
Okay, yeah, sorry. Gibu's been saying that a ton in the chat.
Right, sorry. Okay. I'm still not... I have to look in a different place for chat now, and I'm still not quite used to it, I guess. Yeah, that's a problem. Okay, yeah, so show on HUD would be a really good idea. Because then what I can do is I can basically give these all random numbers and then work out which ones I need to swap. That's probably the easiest way of doing it? No. Stop deleting thingies. There we go. Whoops, did I not? Oh, I probably didn't select them, did I? Runway. Here we go. Show on hood. Must have an active antenna connected. Do we not have one? I don't think we have one.
We do.
Is it this thing? This should be one, right? Is it on? I mean, this explains why we can't find the ship without without having a GPS.
Isn't that antenna up there connected? I even ground it down and then rewelded.
Oh, it's called something different though, isn't it? In like intruders.
Oh yeah, and broadcasting could be off potentially.
It's not called intruders.
What if that's why we haven't been attacked by like pirates or anything? Is because our antenna's been off.
Depressurize. No trespassers. There we go. That's the one. Enable broadcasting is off, so that's not useful.
You could rename it.
Adlipsoid. Oh, I just show ship name, right? I don't think I need to. Oh no, it went. I've lost it forever.
Rip.
It's gone. It cancelled. It cancelled and disappeared forever. Oh well. Okay.
Oh, they're all on. They're all being broadcast now.
Yeah. Oh, come on.
Even on my HUD.
Pirates don't react to your antennas. That's a myth. I have no idea where it originated from. Oh, nice. Wait, and then search by incomplete. Oh, that's a pro tip. That is an absolutely pro tip. Let's make it unfunctional.
Man, it is flashing. Did you mean to do that? On my HUD, it is the broadcasting. Oh. Okay.
No, it's because I was damaging it. If it gets damaged, it's gone. It's not even in here. It's not part of the ship anymore. You have to just grind it down and completely rebuild it.
Do you want me to try?
I mean, we probably want it in a different place anyway, I think, but we've got a turret, reactor, medical room, and a missile turret that are all incomplete, but it doesn't have the antenna. It's like the antenna has never existed.
Yeah.
What the hell is going on here? Why do we have
I kind of do like this location, because it's kind of out of the way of the dock.
What was that? What's going on?
Uh-oh. Missile turret shooting at shit.
What's it shooting at? No, it's just moving around. It's just doing its thing. Oh. Man, it looks pretty great, though. That's a good-looking missile turret right there.
I'm telling it to not target anything except meteors. I thought it was had its sights on something.
Yeah. Okay, so now I need to grind the antenna down and then back up again, really. But it's so expensive. Is there a better place that we can put the antenna?
I actually liked where it was. There's probably a better place, but the reason I liked it kind of where it was is it was out of the way. Like, yeah. It wasn't in, like, flight paths that we normally take. Like, if you put it anywhere on the top of the saucer, it's going to interfere with docking some ship.
Yeah. No, that makes sense. That's fine. I'll just grind it down first, then. The problem is I can't grind it down and build it if it's in the same spot, but I can just... Because I don't have enough inventory space to...
Oh, then here, let me help.
Oh, it's okay. I just put it in the connector, so I'll just go pick it up from the connector.
I was about to say, it's a team game.
It is a team game. And I'm glad it is. It's important. Important to me that it is. Okay. Tubes, computer, radio components. Boom.
Yeah, below the saucer would work too, like next to the spy, the pylon.
Hmm. Yeah, that's true. So should we put it there then?
Yeah. I like it. So should I have the missile turret target meteors or just target nothing actually until we need it? Because I feel like if it shoots meteors, it's going to be a waste of missiles.
Probably, yeah.
And its range is 800 meters.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I like it. I like it here. I think this is a good place.
Oh, there's a military escort.
Not going to be in the way of anything.
6 clicks away.
Large steel tubes and some more steel plates. Perfect spot. There we go. It's Gibu approved. Nice. Antenna's being built. Oh, a meteor just hit the saucer. I didn't see it. Uh-oh. Oh man, your weld is so much better than this one. Where did it collide?
Yeah, I thought collision damage.
It's only done a little bit of a dent here though. We lost some metal grids, but that's about it. And I think in fact there's some in this connector. That was good.
Like, are these turrets not shooting it?
They possibly didn't have a firing solution on that load. Oh, this is the builder. It's not docked or not connected or something. Man, I hate this like transparent thing. I know I can increase it, but I'm still halfway through doing the lights, so yeah, it's just a little small cheeky dent. There we go.
Buff it out.
Yeah, it'll buff out. In fact, it did. Right. So, back to here.
It's buffed.
So 4 is 1, 3 is 2. Like, none of them are right. Good. So this is 1. We'll change that to something different. 3 is actually the second one. There's 1, 2. So then we go 9, 6, 5, 8. So it's 3, 9, 6, 5 is right. And that one's 6. Okay, these are all red. And then we just do the offset again. So we start with 0. Drop out this one. Put it up to 20. Drop out this one.
What's the sphere thing?
40.
If you type in, you can type in sphere. And it's just like a iso surface of a sphere.
Oh. Not sure. I'll do that in a second. Just give me a moment.
Shift I to remote. Oh wow, that is sweet.
Oh, now we can use Shift I to get it. Yeah. That's right, I forgot we can do that now. Thank you. Good job, Gibu. Right, everything's now red. Oh, the system works, finally. There we go. So is that in the G menu? Did you see sphere? Oh yeah, that's the voxel thing, isn't it?
I don't know what that means.
So you can change. There's like a creative mode thing where you can modify voxels directly.
So, oh, okay.
And then you can do it with a bunch of different shapes. So. Man, I got rid of all my steel plates. Whoops. Is that going to be too many? It's probably going to be too many if I do that. Nah. Let's try it. I can always remove them later. Let me see. No, I think that will look cool. I think that will be all right.
All right, Gibu, if I wanted to build a missile that I could then control, I know I could do it with a few thrusters and an antenna, but what should be the payload? I want to be able to hit these ships.
Holy crap, that's such a cool idea. You'd have like kamikaze ships.
Exactly, so I was thinking about building a little ship with a remote. I just put a camera in the front, an antenna on it, and then thrusters just in one direction.
Oh, yeah.
So it's basically a missile with a little gyroscope. Because with a gyroscope and one rear thruster, it's kind of all I need to hone in on a ship.
Mm-hmm.
But I want a payload to be kind of tiny, because I want these to be cheap, to where I can just build one, and use a projector to build an array of them, and then be able to use that to send them off.
This is so infuriating, trying to weld this fucking light. It's like the tiniest, stupidest little light in the world. Rotosplosionator, Clangularity, or the Mini Gyro Clang. They're your choices. Look at this.
What has the smallest footprint?
You mean like cheapest to manufacture? Do we want to make loads of them? Is that the thing?
No, I don't care about cost. I care about the size. I want it to become tiny.
Okay.
Because I mean, we have infinite resources.
We do. Essentially, yeah, we really do. You know what? I'm gonna use. So Gibu, I'm looking ship for the. Are you using Gibu ship right now?
No, it's docked.
Okay. It still has welders, right? Yeah, because the welders.
Yep. You have to toggle the main cockpit.
Yeah, but you have to do it when you're out of the ship, don't you? Does it not spaz out if you're in the ship? Well, we're going to find out.
It hasn't spazzed out lately, but you're right. Like, I had to get in and out a couple of times for it to see.
I think that's right. You get in, you change it, and then you get out and get back in again, and then it works fine, I think. Yeah, there we go.
All right, so how do I make the rotor explosionator?
He's being built. Do we even have any resources in here? None of the ones we actually need. Is the cockpit linked? Nope. So what we'll do is we jump in here and we say, "There you go, Gibu ship. All the lovely things that you'd need for a hungry welder." Oh, that's so much better.
A more powerful computer.
Done. Like, literally, like, 40 times faster than what I was doing. Okay, great. So now I can do Shift-I, right? Ah, oh, this is good. Oh, I did the wrong thing. Let's go again. Shift-I. Padlipsoid. Terminal. Interior light. Let's see. So it should be everything from 31 onwards to 56. 50 of your sixes. Yeah, that was nice and bright. And now we need to rename all of them. Runway light, Western. White. It doesn't matter whether it's port or starboard anymore. I'm gonna keep doing this.
And what's the range of an antenna again? I don't remember.
You can modify it and it's up to 50k, I think, something like that.
Oh, okay, so I don't need to like use some fancy laser antenna.
Yeah, Oh, you can use laser antennae. They're like a separate thing, so they can be used as relays, but you need to have line of sight for those.
But like for my little missile, I should be able to hit anything within 10 kilometers. Then with just a standard
antenna.
I
get you. Yeah, for the control of it. Yeah, I think so. I think so. What do you think? Is that too many? Are you around, Mike?
Yeah.
Are there too many white ones? Do I need to get rid of every other row?
Are you gonna have the white ones flash?
No, they're usually so a normal. This is actually what you'd find at a normal airport. I looked up airport runway lights to get the design.
I mean they're bright. Can you just I would just turn them down.
Just turn them down.
Yeah, their intensity, because they seem to be brighter than they kind of just are washing out the coolness of the red ones.
Oh, whoops. Yeah, I did that wrong. Just a second.
So if you can crank the red ones up and they're fall off and stuff, but
so like something like that.
Yeah, and you could crank, you could change their offset to be like exponential or something. So then as you're coming in, they would get, the red ones would be really bright and red and blinking. And then as you get closer, the white ones light up a lot brighter and it looks actually really cool. Did you turn that on?
I didn't know you could do that, but
yeah, because if you start out like kind of farther where I am and then come in, there you can see the red ones all blinking at a distance.
Oh, I need to turn off.
And then the white ones come in really bright when you get close, so it looks pretty cool.
Okay, nice, nice. There we go. Wait, that's not what I see, right? Like, I don't see the blinking ones until the white ones start coming in, anyway.
Are the red ones on a linear drop-off or exponential?
Linear, I think. But the range is the same, right? So whatever. It's a thing.
It's awesome.
We did a thing. Do you want to fix these doors then?
Right. But yeah. You know, maybe they're really bright because the game, when it does, since it uses RGB, the white has all of the channels on.
Mm-hmm.
And so, depending how they're actually doing the light intensity, the white ones might seem brighter than the reds because the reds are only max red.
Yeah.
So there's two channels that are off.
Could be. So have you been following Gibu's commands for the weapon? So it's a timer block, a small rotor head, which touches and triggers itself. You want a remote block to have separate on, off, and trigger buttons. Test this in a sizable but confined space that can be easily cleared. How sizable is sizable? I mean, is the hangar big enough? But, like, we don't
want
to damage
it. I don't want to damage the hangar.
Yeah. We don't have a confined space that we don't want to get damaged, right? Is this it?
So I still don't... I don't quite understand what the mechanism of, like, destruction is. Like, why, what's the, I don't see the, if I have remote access to the ship, what do I need a timer block for?
What are these blocks called? Oh, it won't damage. It just may only fill. The chaff moves at high enough speed that a cloud of rotor heads overwhelms the armor and decimates systems. This method is really good at angering server admins. That's you, Mike, so...
No, I'm just trying to... I still don't quite understand. Cloud of rotor heads? Like, I don't understand how there's a cloud. It seems like there's a singular rotor head. Or is the idea that you have an array of rotor heads and then you detach them all? Like, I don't quite understand it.
What the hell are these blocks called?
Following it, Blasky.
No, I couldn't. I didn't really understand.
They're called airtight hangar door.
Yeah, but I don't see them in the terminal, which is weird. There's like, I feel like there should be hundreds of them, and if I do airtight,
are they visible? Is that toggled off?
Oh right, maybe. Ah, yeah, here we go. Yeah, there's like 100,000 of them, but they're all grayed out. I see. But the idea was that I can look through here and find the ones that are part of the block group. But actually, it's not showing.
I guess that would work too. Then you could do show on HUD.
Well, that was the plan. Okay, so here are all the things. Where does it... So does it tell me which group this belongs to? I thought it tells you the block group up here. Oh man, this is gonna spam your HUD, sorry.
That's fine.
Oh my god, so many things. Oh, and I've got to just, like, remember the numbers. Okay. Good, because we've got multiples of everything. Good news. Everything's in there twice. Everything open. What's the best way of doing this?
What do you need?
Well, I'm trying to work out which doors are which, but they've not been welded sequentially, so the numbers aren't sequential, and even when they are sequential, most of them are duplicated, because the incrementation thing doesn't work very well.
So the one idea is to damage them all on one side.
I mean, I could maybe, yeah it has to be grinder. One at a time. I can name them, or...
No, why couldn't you just grind that entire row down? And then you would know that entire row belongs to that block group.
Because it will be the ones that are, say, incomplete.
Damaged. Yeah.
Yeah, I think that's the fastest way. Okay, I need... I'm going to need better tools then for this. Because this takes forever otherwise. Yup. Mm-hmm. And then, yeah, I'll name them when I know what they are, so that we never have to do this again, basically. I'm just doing a bit of spring cleaning, really. That's what it feels like. When is the equinox? 21st of March, isn't it? So we've just passed it?
Yeah, I can help with that.
All right. Yeah, I think we just passed it. So, assemble one. Let's get a grinder and a welder at least. It's always good to name things.
Because I'm pretty sure this is how Sydney did it, so I'm just surprised that half of it worked. Like, one row is fine.
Yeah. Alright.
It's also nice that if you get it just beneath the hack level, it doesn't actually add anything to your inventory.
Yeah, which is good. Terminal's not connected. Oh yeah, because I can press this first. Boom. Okay. Airtight. Perfect. So... No. Wait a second. Oh, yeah, okay. I was going to do lower and upper as well, to be more specific.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I can fix that.
Yeah, if you want to just weld those ones back
up
quickly.
I'll take a second.
Yeah, thanks.
Okay.
All right. So now I can get all of these. Oh, I have to go and rename them all manually, don't I? So this is hangar, door, stern... lower.
Sorry, I don't know when the equinox is.
Oh, it's alright.
That's why I didn't say anything.
Jeez, that was like 10 minutes ago. Like, what's...
I know. Well, I just like...
That got queued. That got locked down in your brain queue.
Like,
then.
Sometimes I don't answer because I just don't know the answer. Like, not because I'm not paying attention.
Okay, fine. And I just assumed that we'd passed that point. I was like, okay, fine, yeah. Okay, I'm done with the lower stuff now. So, how about... Okay. I actually don't have a good welder, so how about you weld and I'll grind the top. So
somehow
funny.
Some of these got damaged beyond it, but
oh, I know. Yeah, this grinder is very fast, so
Motor, construction component, small steel tube. Some of these are quite damaged.
Yeah, my inventory is full, so I took a full inventory's worth of stuff. But with the top row, because my inventory's full, I didn't pick up any more. So, there is that. Low access, there we go.
I wanted you to know that, like, I wasn't ignoring you.
I just love how long, like, it was several minutes. No, I appreciate that. Thank you. Thank you for...
Yeah. Sometimes someone doesn't respond. Not because they're not paying attention.
Yeah. Just get stored. Stored back in the queue. More important stuff. I'm going to increase our broadcast radius as well.
Zoe brought it to my attention. That's why I'm...
I thought when you kind of looked at your phone and then immediately came back to the Equinox thing, I was like, that's a command that's been issued there. Or certainly an
command,
alert.
A command, yes.
An alert. An alert.
So I do that to Zoe. And so her the exact quote was... When that happened to you, she's like, I feel you, bro. Like, when you just said it a few times, and you're like, all right, move on.
Okie dokie, off we go.
Okay.
Never mind. I mean, I have all of these, like, pieces. Do you want me to just... I could weld all these for you, honestly.
I mean, it'd be handy.
It would probably be easier. And then I'll just go fill my inventory up again on crap. Okay, don't weld up the other ones yet. I haven't got that far yet. Yep, there you go.
Oh boy, these are missing. These ones are missing shit too. Oh, no, they're not.
No, they're not because my inventory was full.
Only one of them was.
Oh really? Yeah, it's probably the first one then. Okay, if you want to go get the stuff that you need for that, and then I've filled up my inventory, so I can't do this for the others. Right. So, airtight hangar door. So this one is now going to be upper. And then we go boop, boop, boop. Oh, this is going to be so good. We immediately turn them all off so we can't access them anyway, make them all hidden. But we'll know, deep down, we'll know that everything was named correctly. You see, now would be like a perfect time for us to be doing like our Ask Me Anything thing, right? Wouldn't it?
Yeah.
But... It's just Gibu. Like, look at that. Blastbot read my mind.
I am an IRL space engineer. AMA.
Blastbot literally read my mind. There you go. Good.
It was on before you started talking, so you read its mind. You copied it.
I was not. I did not read that, I promise.
All right, is this welding ready now?
Yeah, you can go for it. But yeah, these kind of like mundane bits where we're not really doing anything, like, would probably be a perfect time for that to happen. We just need some more people to like come ask some questions. Oh, that's true. Yeah, Cat's Coffee Chem's probably got plenty of questions. Feel free to ask away.
All right, do you want to try the door control now? Can you make subgroups?
Yeah,
because like you kind of okay. You'd want the doors to be in one group for like turning on and off.
Yeah, you can make groups into. I think you can make a group of groups, but you can't really see the nested group.
Okay.
Thing. So I've just called them all the same thing, which should be sufficient. All right. So.
There's a mining transport 5 clicks away. We've never hit one of those.
Do you wanna try and do that?
Yeah.
All right.
I do.
So this block group would be called Stern Hangar Doors, which we will save. And then, did you die immediately?
Yeah, I ran into, like, did you just start closing the doors or something?
No, did they close automatically, though? All I did was put them in a group. That might have been enough to make them close, I don't know.
I don't know, are their doors closing right now?
They're set to open.
Oh, okay, then. Maybe, I don't know then how I died. Or, like, what I hit. But I hit something and instantly died, so I gotta go grab all that shit.
I think you are absolutely right there, Gibu. That the groups are just objects that contain lists of references to the blocks, not the other way around. So you can make as many groups as you want on whatever you want. But the blocks don't realize that. And that explains why when I was looking for the name of the group, I couldn't find it. We have our first question. Would you rather fight 100 duck-sized horses or one horse-sized duck?
I'd rather fight the 100. Like, I think I could kick... I think a duck-sized horse would be terrifying. A horse-sized duck.
A horse-sized duck. I mean. Duck, you know,
like,
that's...
that bill...
Jeez,
ugh, could
that
could...
And some of the bills are pretty sharp as well, right? Like, we'd have some problems there. But then 100, like you always say, like when we're out walking around with the geese, it's like you could easily take a goose, right? But when there's a pack of like even 7 of them, you're like your ankles are gonna get nibbled away at. Gibby says he'd go with the zombie-sized chickens. I mean, that seems like a valid.
No, I had my eye pecked by a chicken once. That was sitting on my shoulder. You don't want to fuck with those things. Oh, like,
that doesn't sound good. I don't like the sound of that all right, at all.
I'm at the mining transport.
Okay. Do you need help or are you good?
I don't know yet. I'm out of turret range because I'm trying to see if they have a blind. How I can move stay outside of their firing solution here.
Oh, Minecraft story mode reference. I never actually played the story mode, honestly.
There's a story mode?
Yeah,
just like survival.
I think it was only released when Microsoft took hold of it. I don't know how good it is. Perhaps it's good. I'm not sure. I've not played Minecraft in many, many years. Many years. Okay, I don't know. Oh, I guess I should turn all of these things off the HUD. We don't need that anymore. Hangar doors. Let's get all of these. No. Bollocks. That's not what I wanted. That is not what I wanted.
Alright, it's requesting assistance, but I hopefully can shoot this thing in time.
While we're still working on him.
Okay, so it's antennas down.
You got it? Nice.
But...
there we go. Oh, so much better. Oh, I've got no oxygen again. I was about to come out and help you, but I'm gonna suffocate if I do.
I need to see what I'm working with here.
Oh, wait, hang on. Minecraft story mode is...
oh, God. There's an interior turret. Oh, my God. I almost just fucking ate it.
Almost? Did you survive?
I ground the door down, and then the interior turret opened fire on me, just like I said they should do.
There you go. Troll developers. Tra-la-la-la-la.
I'm out of ammo. Okay, this just got a little more interesting.
What do I have in the way of ammo? I've got three clips.
Okay, I found 2 reactors. So I'm hoping that I can kind of get to these out of turret range and then just grind them. And if both of these turn off the stuff, then we should be fine.
Gibu's like...
but if there's any batteries...
Gibu says the assistants only calls assailants, which are easy if you have a hammerhead frigate or something. Gibu, you know full well we have nothing of the sort. Like,
okay, this... We're safe. There were only two reactors, and I found them. So everything should be turned off.
Okay,
but if you want to come and look at this thing, you can. It's pretty cool.
I'm right here, yeah. Did you do the turrets on the outside? Did you grind
them?
No,
I haven't hacked them or anything.
Okay, so now's a good time to do that, right? Given that...
yeah.
Oh man, I gotta turn dampers off.
I was gonna go inside and get the interior turret.
Life very different.
Because that thing almost... wasted me here.
I mean, this ship looks cool.
Yeah, it should be pretty full of stuff.
It's a shame we still don't have a large reactor has worth of reactor components yet, do we?
Did you do something with the large cargo container? Did you mean to grind it down?
I might have accidentally hit it. No, I didn't. Okay. But I can. Do you want me to?
Yeah. Well, no, it's the other. There's one that is ground down for sure. It was accidentally ground down.
Oh, maybe I did hit it on the other side. If there's one on this side.
I just don't have the stuff to fix it.
Oh, right. Yeah, right here. Sorry. Oh, wait. No, I don't have the stuff to fix it either.
It needs a display.
I don't have a display. Hunter, it's in Danvers office by yourself. Yeah, you're right.
Wow, there's a ton of gold on there.
Oh, cool. So are we still... We're still moving, right?
Yeah, I'm working my way to the... cockpit.
I found a door. Like, what does this door lead to? Oh. Yeah, that's where you were.
I've already hacked it.
Oh, I see, and you welded it back up. I just welded it back down again. Sorry.
There's a gravity generator, too. I don't know why.
Oh, yeah, we have gravity.
If you got the exterior turrets, I got the interior one, so it should be safe to turn the reactors back on.
Yeah, should be. Yeah, because right. I can't actually get through the door. That's the problem that I was having. Like, you weld the door back up after you, but there's no power, so I can't open it again.
Alright, not me then.
Did you do the control station?
Yeah, it's ours.
Okay, perfect.
You should be able to sit in it. I'll give you reactor power.
Okay, I've turned the dampeners on. If you give me reactor power, we should slow down.
And you got all the turrets, right?
I got both of the ones on the outside. I don't know if there's any more, but
all right.
I didn't see any.
We'll find out.
Well, good luck. Sorry if I got that wrong. We'll find it out very quickly.
Somehow I don't have the stuff I need. I don't know how this happens.
Sometimes they get destroyed.
I need some motors.
Right, there are certain things you don't get back. So what are you missing?
Motors.
I got 55 motors. I can come do it.
Okay. Did you hack the gyroscopes?
Nope.
Alright, I'll do that if you want to fix the...
Oh, do you need to? Do you need to have the gyroscopes?
Two reactors. You'll want... Oh, yeah, you know, there's a hack level on them. So I figured if there's a hack level on them, then there's a...
Okay.
Ownership.
So I believe... It should be slowing down, right? Is the ship coming to a stop? Is it very, very slowly coming to a stop? Is that what's going on here?
Are we missing an axis?
I don't. Maybe I turned the dampeners on when I got in. No, it's slowing down. It's just taking a while. I think it's just a very slow ship, honestly. Gibu says.
Oh man, there's a refinery on this too.
I'm just, yeah.
Two large refineries.
Oh, that's cool. The reason I ask about the gyros is that I didn't hack the gyros in the mining carriage and was able to fly it back just fine.
Well, I just got killed by an interior turret.
Second one?
There's two.
Where's the
I don't one? Know where the other one is. Well, the other one is the one that killed me, so watch out. You might want to take out the reactor again.
Oh, okay. Oh, was there
than one door?
Bye, Mike. Bye, friend.
Did you say you found another door?
It's like
we might want to turn off the reactors, or you might get wasted by that.
He's just flying off. I was just watching you fly off like a little butterfly. Oh. It was glorious. Right. So there's a second reactor. Yeah, there were two doors, but you'd done both of them, so you've seen both of the doors. So there wasn't like a door that you were missing or anything.
So then, did I just get killed? Did that turret not get hacked? I thought I hacked it.
I don't know. You said you had, so I can't imagine you'd have said you had if you hadn't.
Well, somehow it killed me, so you might want to get rid of that turret or hack it.
It looks like the ship is falling into the planet's gravity. That's a problem. Oh no! Here we go again.
Do you need help?
I'm hoping. I don't think there's a second turret anywhere. Whereabouts did you die? Were you in the control room?
The main control room then.
There must be the only one to it. I guess you didn't hack it then.
Yeah.
But I can't.
But
I can't
it should
have
be safe
the...
now.
Yeah, it should be safe, but I can't fly it back without power, so I gotta weld everything back up again. So if there is a second one somewhere, then I'm just gonna die too, but I didn't see one.
So, I mean, then you should be fine, as long as you don't go in some other random... So I went into where there's a refinery, by refineries on the bottom.
Okay, there's probably another turret then. I didn't...
But there's not another turret in a spot where you're going to accidentally run into if you just go to the cockpit
and
fly it
which
back,
is where I am right now. So I'm going to get this flight, fly this baby back. Which way is forwards in this thing? What the... How is this meant to... Okay, this is the way it's meant to fly. All right. I guess that's fine. Where is home? Oh, it must be the green one, right? Because we're now broadcasting, so it's probably this way. I think this thing is very full. It's extremely slow, certainly.
Well, and it's got two huge refineries on it.
Mm-hmm. Is that what these, like, little nacelles are?
Yeah.
Ah.
And that's what I went to explore, and then I ran... I feel better now. If there really is another interior turret chilling around, which I guess you could check with the control panel.
Oh, yeah, right. That's a good call.
Then I'll feel okay.
I will do
especially that. Especially since that one didn't shoot you, I'm pretty sure it was, like, another interior turret.
It only looks like there's one.
Then that must have been just not hacked.
Yeah.
I'm just glad it killed me and not you then.
Yeah, no, I got... Well, after you died, I just ground the power back down again. And then it seemed fine.
Ooh, what's the elite automatic rifle?
Don't crush it. Yeah, no joking. We explored those on the surface of the planet, remember?
No, I thought we explored precise... And rapid fire.
Yeah, we didn't make the elite one because we looked it up and it's just like a little bit more damage or something. It's like better stats, but it's not different enough.
Oh, I thought we just couldn't make it because it had platinum and silver.
Oh shit, maybe. Yeah, we didn't have platinum on the surface, so I must have got that wrong.
So I just built it. We'll see.
See what it's like. See if it's any good. Huh. And this thing is pretty fast. Oh, it's both rapid and accurate, so it's a combination of the two. Yeah.
Oh, well, sweet.
That sounds pretty good then, doesn't it?
I wonder... Remember how it had a scope? I wonder if that helps now.
Yeah, maybe. So where's the connector? Oh, I see them. There's loads, actually. I don't think I can land the ship anywhere. I think going into the cargo bay is going to be the best bet. So this is going to be good. This will be good for a laugh. Hold on to your horses, everybody.
Oh, don't. Please don't. Just leave it outside. we'll build a better connection tube. Like, please don't try to land that.
I'm going to give it a shot. We're going to do it.
Oh, boy. RIP server. I'm doing a save right now.
Okay, do the save.
Alright, we're saved. All right. We're ready for the save scrum.
I don't even think it'll fit, actually, in the hangar. Crap, which direction is... Man, I don't even know which axes I'm using. I mean, I got this completely under control, don't worry. Everything's fine. Obviously.
Don't worry. Yeah, Yibu's with me on this. Yeah, it'll be entertaining. Fine.
Okay.
Yeah, that's not gonna fit.
I don't think that's gonna fit, is it? It's too big. And I can't land it on the top. So
careful. You're swinging around in the interior turrets, flashing me.
Oh, is it? Well, the interior turret is. I hacked it again, so the interior turret's fine now.
Okay.
Again, when the power was down, I sorted all that. That's how I got into the cockpit, right? I wouldn't have been able to otherwise. Ah, oh, very good. I would totally go for landing it if it would fit, and I don't think it fits. Right? I mean, we can count. Let's see. This is 1, 2, 3, and then this is a 3x3, right? So 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. It's 9 blocks tall, and our hanger is, well, the hanger is fine, but the door is 1, 2, 3, 4. So, yes, there is.
You could land it on the deck.
I could land it. Yeah. All right. I'll land it then. Can I land it on the other side where I've not spent like 2 hours doing the lights?
Oh, the confidence shines through.
Yeah. I don't see you hollering it, you know, cracking the whip to try and land the damn thing, so, you know.
Because I think it's an awful idea. Not because I don't want to do the work. Oh.
Oh, God.
Those antennas are scraping almost. On the roof.
I know. I noticed that. Oh, this is already destroyed because of the...
It's had a few meteor dings.
The meteor shower, so... This is a very large ship.
It's massive.
This is a
It will be a good one to grind. Honestly, if those landing pads let you land on the ship. Because if it does, it'll make it easy to grind.
Oh, you mean like actually make it part of the ship?
Yeah. Or no, just let like magnetize and dock.
Oh,
or they only do that on Earth.
Yeah, because we've got little...
Oh, yeah, you got... It's yellow.
We've got partial contact. So I need to go space.
You've got room.
I need to go vertically upwards, which is this way.
They're both good now.
Actually forwards. Hang on. Parking it in the middle. Oh. And then I go forwards to go down. There we go. Yeah?
Yep, you're clear. All right.
Oh. Slightly glitchy. Can I get out? Just about get out.
What's in the cargo bay?
I don't know. I didn't check, actually. Because we have to grind it down and back up again, don't we? So.
This one's got silver and silicon. Or gold. Yeah, gold and silicon.
Game glitch. Don't jinx it. Don't let that happen. Oh, I didn't check the other one. Yeah, silicon and gold. Let's see. The other one has nothing at all. It's completely empty.
Ooh, the refinery has a bunch of platinum.
Platinum and silicon.
Can you get this other refinery? Maybe, or did it just get damaged?
Where is the... where's the other refinery?
The other right over here.
I actually
I'm
didn't...
at it.
Wait, where are you? I've lost you.
Do you see me or?
Yes, I do now. Yep.
This is where the other refinery is.
Oh, I see. Cool. Nice. Yeah, I can weld this up. I think that's your end, Gibu. We're not dropping any frames on this side. We have dropped 0.4% of frames, which is about normal, and it usually happens right at the beginning of the stream, right when we're starting to swap between the different scenes.
One more steel tube. Just one.
Large?
One large steel tube.
Yeah, I'm bringing it. Here we go. Ta-da!
And then we can let it...
Yeah, might as well let it refine, right? Because that saves time for us. This is just going to sit here until we grind it down, so... May as well. Oh, did you get... Oh, it's buffering and dropping frames on your end too. Oh. What are you doing, Twitch?
Does that mean it's a Twitch problem? Like, if it's not a problem between yours, like...
Honestly, I didn't check. So with Restream, the only ever dropped frames were always right at the beginning. It could be that those dropped frames were just then. Because, you know, it's 0.4%, but that's 2,000 frames. And 2,000 frames is like a good couple of seconds.
Mm-hmm.
So, maybe it was just then. I'll keep an eye on it. Let me know again if it happens.
Do you want me to start grinding the ship down? Because I can start on the back.
Yeah, you can if you want. Yeah. I guess I can go ahead and do the other side of the hangar doors, and then it might be nearly bedtime. Let's see. Do we have a welder? I made one. I maked this. Oh. We don't have a welder.
Yeah, that's worked without fail now, actually, the in and out.
Yeah, I think
you said it.
That was what we were missing, wasn't it?
That epic, glorious comic.
Beautiful comic. So good. Absolutely amazing. Found it. Boom. There we go. Oh yeah, now I need to fill my inventory up with crap. That's not enough crap. I need more crap than that. There's loads of crap in this one. Yeah, there's loads of crap. Look at this. Thousands of crap.
Yeah, because this was a large ship, so we're gonna have so much.
Yeah. It's just a shame it only had small reactors on it.
I know, we need to find the...
Yeah. Although we might be getting close to like having enough either raw resources or just small reactor components, because it's the same reactor components, just less of them, right? But if we grind down like 10 small reactors, maybe we're getting close.
10 might be right. I think it needs 2,000.
Right. So, did you pick up Hacknet Labyrinth or not?
No.
You've got to, like, it was great. I really enjoyed it. You played the original, right?
Yeah.
I know there's some like terminal issues, but I think actually now you can change directory using the absolute things, which we mentioned that you couldn't do in the original. You can use relative path commands.
Nice.
Which you couldn't do before, which is cool. But I thoroughly recommend that game. Anyone who is even slightly interested in programming, it's not a game about programming, it's a game about hacking, but it actually uses real Linux commands in order to do that. And it really makes you feel like a hacker. It's incredibly immersive. The story is fantastic. Like, story, right, in a hacking game. Yeah, it was pretty exceptional. And the DLC just came out a few days ago and I picked it up and played it. It's only about... I think the normal game is about 8 hours, and I think the DLC, they say it's 4, I think it took me about 6, because I tried to do everything. So I just kind of played it over the weekend, and man, that last mission, that was extreme. So intense.
Was it like a camping mission?
It was not.
Alright, I got all the ingots out, so now it's ready for full decon.
Cool. Oh no, I don't want this. Oh no, I pressed escape. That wasn't what I meant. I didn't mean to do that. Hangar door. Yeah, so... yeah. Here. Can I just paste it? Oh, I even have it. Look at that. Bow. Upper. Oop. I was looking at other hacking games as well, and I found like a top 10 list, and Hacknet came in as number 2. Number 3 was Uplink. You remember Uplink, right?
Oh my god, that game was so good. I loved it so much.
I loved Uplink.
I remember how I like stumbled upon it. Like,
yeah.
I don't know if it was ever a big game.
No, it's like, very cult classic.
But like, yeah.
So it's made by Introversion Software. And they're just a very, very small, I think it's actually only two guys. Maybe they have like a couple of art people as well, but it's two main guys who created a game called Darwinia.
Yeah, I played Darwinia.
Right, I think that was more popular than Uplink was.
And then, yeah, I think I learned about Darwinia because I was looking up, after playing Uplink, I'm like, oh my god, like,
yeah,
sequel, is there another more game? Like...
that's it, absolutely. Yeah, so I think it's just a tiny British company. I have no idea where I first discovered about Darwinia, but Darwinia was the first thing I found. Then there was Uplink, and then there was a nuclear warhead simulation game called DEFCON, which was pretty fun.
Yeah, is that another one of their games?
It is, yeah.
I played every one of their games then. Like, I remember, like, after, like, loving that game, I you just went looked for more. DEFCON was pretty good. I really liked it, actually.
I liked DEFCON as well, but they had it the wrong way around. They had DEFCON 3 as, like, the highest level, which is the wrong way around. DEFCON 1 is the highest, and 3 is the lowest. But other than that, it was pretty good. Yeah, they made Multiwinia as well, which was, like, it was a Darwinia clone, but multiplayer. I mean, Darwinia was a weird game, right? It was a pretty odd concept. It was fun. I enjoyed it, but it was...
you had to, like, what, capture stuff, and then you get little minions, and you
move
them
around. Yeah, that's right, but you couldn't control things directly. You had to just influence the world in order to move things around and stuff. It was a cool... it was a novel concept. It was pretty odd storyline, though, I seem to remember. But they pretty much completely faded into obscurity until recently they created Prison Architect. Have you heard of Prison Architect, Mike?
That's also their game?
Yeah, it's the same guys. It's very different.
Yeah, but... I pirated that game and played a lot of it.
It's super good. It's a really fun prison simulator. But you build the prison up, and then you have to keep your prisoners happy. And then riots are breaking out, and people are getting shivved in the shower, and the usual stuff.
It's really fun. Why is there a row missing down here?
I'm halfway through doing it. Hang on.
Okay. You are going for, like, completionist here and also naming that side.
I am doing the full thing. Well, this was the side that was broken, if you remember. The other side worked, so we actually hadn't done anything.
Oh. Had I known, I would have not really pushed for that.
No, that's okay. Don't worry. Oh, this isn't upper anymore. This is now lower. So Gibu says he's played one non-free game, which is Space Engineers. Free games, Flash games... maybe if I'm extremely bored, but currently I'd either be working or I'd rather do some creative programming or this art stuff and such and the like and so on and so forth, etc. Which is, you basically said.
Creeper, I played Creeper World, I think like the first one. It was a really novel concept. Like it was a two-dimensional game where there, I think it was like pseudo three-dimensional. But like there's this, you'd be, like it's kind of like honestly like a tower defense game. Oh. Where you'd have this like liquid basically... move around the map and it would follow normal like gravity if it was up a hill or it could fill a valley, and then you would have like little turrets you could use to shoot the liquid, and the goal was to like either clear the liquid from the map or it's pretty interesting.
That's pretty cool.
I really like it. That's a blast from the past, Gibu.
I don't know about this. I've never heard of it. Uh, Apparently Creeper World 3 is like 1, but better.
Because I heard Creeper World 2 wasn't that good or something. But, yeah, I'll have to maybe check it out. Do you like incremental games, Gibu? Like Cookie Clicker? Or games like Cookie Clicker?
I don't know that one either. You want to give us a lowdown?
So incremental games, incremental clicking games are games typically where you have to, like, click and you get a cookie. You click on this cookie, you get a cookie. You keep clicking on the cookie and eventually you can, like, buy an upgrade that automatically makes more cookies. And it just kind of spirals out from there. And if it sounds dumb, you must play it, because it's one of those games that's like, you start playing it and the next thing you know, it's supposed to be like an idle game,
yeah,
where you can like let it run and then go do something off in the browser. Like if you buy something that auto clicks like one cookie a second, you go do something else and it shows,
yeah,
up.
So it does sound dumb, but you're speaking to someone who has absolutely min-maxed Clicker Heroes, which has the exact same concept. And I love Clicker Heroes. It's great. I thoroughly admit though, it's a stupid concept for a game, but it's so much fun. And yeah, I really enjoy it. So again, you get that auto clicking thing, you go through different levels, but then there's some like persistence. So you eventually get to a point where, like, certainly in Clicker Heroes, I don't know if this is the same in Cookie Clicker. What do
you basically have to Cookie Clicker. You basically prestige.
Right. Yeah. So eventually you get to a point where everything kind of grinds to a halt, but then you can restart, but you get like a persistent bonus. Right. Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. No, it's identical mechanic. I don't know where it fit in the order of games. But most games follow, like most incremental games. There's a subreddit that's R incremental games where people post them all, but they pretty much all follow that same formula.
Yeah. Okay. That's pretty great. No, I really like them. I think they're good fun.
Yoctillion cookies per second. And it has a great story. I don't know if Clicker Heroes does, but Not Cookie really. Clicker actually has like a story.
Oh, cool. I'll have to look that up.
It's kind of fun.
Yeah. Man, I forget what I saved the block group as. Carrier bow hanger doors is what I want. All right. Hanger door bow.
This is kind of tricky to grind, because if I grind out the reactor, it loses its magnetic connection.
Oh, does it?
Yeah, because I don't think you get power through landing pads.
Ah, yeah. Okay, then all of these hangar doors...
Right? Like, you get power through connector tubes.
Yeah, I think you're right. I got this, don't worry. Oh, maybe you've got it. I should probably get out of the way if you're grinding stuff away.
Sorry.
It's all good.
I just wanted to get the ore detector piece because that was like a big chunk.
I got those. Barrage of meteors targets the link between your hangar and the rest of the ship. Oh no. We have so many turrets though. Wait, do we have this many turrets on the bottom though? Because... Yeah, we've got one on the bottom. Not super.
We have
protected.
A decent turret coverage, yet we still seem to be hammered with them all the time.
Like all the time. Never mind. You're doing a good job here, mate. This is looking nice.
I'm trying to be intentional. So, like, I think what I'll do is get these two, get some of these engines, and then go for a reactor on one side to see if it. Because I think it will float away, though, if I do the reactors.
Right.
Or not the reactors, refineries.
The refinery, yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So I'm trying to get everything else first.
So I'm gonna have a quick look at the large reactor that you started to place, right? Because you started to weld it up, didn't you? And then we just found we didn't have enough reactor components.
Yeah, or like it just seemed really like a huge sink of reactor components.
Yeah. Yeah, okay. I'm going to see if we have enough to get in here. Oh, we need superconductor conduits as well, but they're pretty cheap, aren't they? I only need 100 of them. Seems a little straightforward. Let's see. Reactor components. We have 104. I guess I can probably put them all in the same place. Would be useful. Wow. Yeah. We don't have that many at all. We've got 500. I mean, I guess that's a quarter. It's not too far off, is it? How much are superconductor conduits? Yeah, they're pretty easy. So we get 100 of these.
Oh, sorry, Sydney. We're kind of wrapping up.
I think so. Yeah, yeah.
I mean, the VOD will be there, I suppose.
We've not done that much, honestly. I can give you a bit of a...
We've not done that much.
We've not done... So, I didn't finish because I was like, hey, I can just show you. We've done a lot of housekeeping-related stuff. And we picked up another couple of ships, didn't we, as well? That are being ground down. But we've got a missile turret on the top now, which is pretty nice. We've got the antenna broadcasting, which it wasn't doing before, which is kind of annoying.
It solves a lot of problems.
Uh-huh. Some new lights. And we have fixed the hangar doors. So now the hangar doors function correctly and are named correctly as well. So we have... Uh-oh. We've got two. Why do we have two of these? One of the ones is the one that was there previously, and one of the ones is the one I did. I think that one's mine because it says they're open. I think if we get rid of this, it should work. So we can close the stern hangar doors. There we go. On that side. Can I actually even close these doors? Yeah, you're not. Just wanted to make sure I wasn't cutting out half the ship if I did this.
And so I guess I lied. It looks like you do get power through landing pads. I didn't think you did.
Oh, okay. Huh. That's pretty cool.
Because, yeah, it's still green, but there's no connector. Or there's no, like, reactor connecting it.
Oh, interesting. That one's, like, wobbling around in a really weird way. We have had pretty much no server problems, actually. Right?
Yay. Oh, watch out. I'm grabbing that.
Okay, sorry. Are these now disconnectors? Oh, I got it.
Like little feet. Sorry, I'm trying to just get the big pieces now. We have so many steel plates after these operations that like...
Just like hundreds and hundreds of steel plates. On the top. Just showboating right now. Aw, oh, mate. There's stuff floating off into space.
We can clean those up later.
I'm off to them. I've got him.
Alright. Oh, like you're like a space cowboy here. NSYNC would be proud.
Well, nice and filling.
Wrestling the floating, the free range space components.
That's it. No. Oh, I think. Oh, I might have just pinged an interior light off into the depths of space.
Oh man, this whole thing's floating off now.
Uh oh.
Hey, little doggy. I'm afraid to grind. I'm afraid I'm gonna grind a door.
Wait, where's home?
I'll be careful.
Where am I? I'm lost in space. No, I'm fine. So what? Oh, I see a bit. There's a bit floating off over here. I'll go this bit. I can't promise that, Gibu. I can't promise that I can read the comic again without cracking up. I don't think that's possible. I can give it my best shot, though. Yeah, we'll do that at the close of stream, which is going to be like probably right now. We're just going to finish grinding this stuff up.
Yeah, once it's all ground down, we can...
And then get ourselves into the cryo chambers. Bit of cryo sleep.
And then you wake up and be confused where you are.
Oh no, it's the worst. Worst feeling. What's going on here? Why can't I get this down? Does this not exist? Is that the problem? Is there a bit here that doesn't exist? Actually, where are you? Oh, there you are.
I'm back.
I can't get
there's up. A piece.
Is there a landing gear under here?
No, the landing gear's over there. It's still stuck on the ground. Do you see it?
Yeah, is it this
on the
one?
Flight deck. Yeah, there's only two landing gear.
Yeah, I think there's a desync.
Okay.
Because there's a landing gear here, but I can't grind it down.
Sorry, there's a landing gear on my screen that's attached still to the deck.
Okay, yeah, this isn't attached. In fact, I think I can probably push this off into space. No, it won't let me.
Alright, so I'm right now grinding where the landing gear really is. So I don't know what that looks like to you.
Yeah, it looked pretty different, but then it just vanished on my screen when you got it, so.
Okay, so I need to shift I. Oh, we don't have a remote block on our ship.
A remote block on Gibu's ship?
On the paralipsoidal thing.
What do we need a remote? What are you trying to do?
Open the door?
You can do that. It's got an antenna, so you only need an antenna.
You don't need a remote block?
No. So, bow, open. Boop.
It says wrong ownership for me, too, so that's odd. I don't know how a welder fell off this thing. Oh, well.
Oh, yeah.
So, will this pressurize?
There's no vents, so no. Right?
Oh, okay.
It would if we had a vent. In fact, we could put a vent in. A single vent here. Can you imagine one vent to do all of this?
Yeah.
That'd be crazy.
Alright. I like how the grinder is like Egypt. So you don't have to manually move things around.
Yeah, it's pretty good. Alright, okay. Cry of sleep. And then comic.
Bedtime.
And then beddies.
Doors are all sealed.
Yeah, looks like it. Yeah, it would be a huge waste of oxygen to pump all that, because as soon as you open the doors again, it all disappears, so. That would not be good.
Yeah, plus we're not airtight down here. Oh, you meant.
Oh, sorry. Tra-la-la-la-la. Oh, there is a vent here. Huh.
Yeah, but this one's still open. What?
Yeah, you just pushed me out of the way. What's that all about?
Oh, sorry. I don't know. That was weird. Like, I don't know how it was, like, exactly.
I know. It's like we just got, like, stuck to you or something. All right. Okay, so I'm just going to quit for... Oh, it doesn't matter. I guess you can kill a server while I'm...
Yep. Save. Exit to main menu. Yes.
Oh, there we go.
Exit. Man, this was the first time I think we had a play that we didn't end up having to, like, reload a save after everything's gone horribly.
Right. You're absolutely right. Alright. One more run through the comic. The comic of Destiny. Are you ready to do your bit, Mike, when it comes up?
I got it.
You got it. Okay. Everybody, the amazing work.
It's hard because the audio is delayed. The audio's on time, the video's delayed, so.
Okay, yeah, that's true. Well, I mean, I have a bit to read before your bit, so just when I stop talking, you come in with your bit, even if you can't quite see it.
Okay, I think I got it memorized.
We should be fine.
I did have a minor part in it all.
Yeah. This is like that thing you were talking about on stream the other night. Yeah. You did the one line.
Yeah, it was not one line.
Alright, anyway, enough. So, Gibu, sorry, I give you the amazing creative talent that is our very own game, Gibu. Hello everyone, and welcome back to Blaskatronic TV, your number one choice for watching a British man play video games. And today we're back with some more Rocket League. As always, I'm joined by Mike and Shmev. Oh dear, it looks as if we have some technical issues. Oh, Gibu's here. Hi guys, hey, I'm sorry I didn't get the comic to you sooner. I just wanted to make sure I got the hair right and spent a lot of time trying to blah 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 blah. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Calm down. You don't have to apologize for anything. We understand, Gibu. I want you to know I really appreciate you taking the time to do the comic, and I can't wait to see it, but you gotta take your time.
Oh, Gibu's here. Beep boop.
Perfect. Oh god, I love this bit. Right then, let's get to it, shall we? Start stream. Yep, botched intro. Double yes. Gibu's here. Great. Beep boop. Good. So we've got to say something quite British and probably say calculated a few times as well. Great. Are we good to go? Let's see if we can win a few games this time round. How's that sound, Gibu?
Way anchor.
Oh dear. I zoomed out by accident. Much later. Some wicked sick rainbow aerials pulled off by whoever's driving this beautiful machine. Boosh. Good job, everyone. Great play. Gibu with the clips, as always, and a cheeky kaboom. Excellent. Mike's really been going ham these past few rounds. Calculated. Chat disabled for 4 seconds. All I have to do is go forward. Gaming with Colby has joined the chat. Oh, here we go. Lag. Seems we're going to need some intervention here. Release the chat mod. Thank you so much, Gibu.
It's so good. I love it.
Absolutely brilliant.
You need to include a link to this in our, like, stream.
I can do that. Yeah, page. I can...
It deserves that kind of attention.
I can put it on the channel because it doesn't limit the vertical size of an image. It only limits the width. So it will shrink it down to 300 pixels along the width. But I'll see if I can put it on the channel and put it in there. But absolutely brilliant stuff, Gibu. Thank you again for that. That's great.
So good.
It took him 12 hours. It was worth every second. Absolutely every second. All right, thank you so much everyone for coming out and joining us playing a bit of Space Engineers. Next stream will be Tuesday night, probably. Maybe do a bonus on Monday, but I wouldn't count on it, honestly. We'll see. Next scheduled stream will of course be Tuesday evening. I hope to see you there. Please come out and join us. It's bye from me. Bye from Mike, maybe?
Bye from me. Sorry, I didn't
really cue you, and we've never done that. There is absolutely no reason that you would know.
I know, and even then, bye from me?
The thing is, there's a British panel show where they do that, and we say, it's goodbye from such and such a person, and then they say goodbye, and then goodbye from blah, 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 and then they say goodbye, and goodbye from me. And it just kind of flows naturally because it's expected, right? But I should have given you more of a cue. But anyway, I digress. Good night, everybody. Thank you for coming out, and see you all next time.
Good night, and good luck.